Hi students, today we talk about what are the methods in fish culture. And here there are four types: monoculture, monosex culture, polyculture and integrated fish farming. And here the first one is monoculture. The culture of single species in a pond is called monoculture. It is also called monospecies culture. Carp, tilapia, mullet, milkfish, air-breathing fishes, prawns, etc. are cultured by monoculture method. In monoculture, the pond is stocked with only one age group or with different age groups. Stocking fishes with only one age group is called monosize stocking. Stocking fish with different age group is one pond is called multi-size stocking. The second one is monosex culture, which means culturing of only one sex, either male or female, of a fish in a pond is called monosex culture. Monosex culture can be following fishes: tilapia, mozambica, sunfishes. Then need for monosex culture. Tilapia is a rapid breeder. In short period, it's overpopulated. When both male and female are present in the same pond, large amount of energy is wasted for the breeding. When only male or female is cultured in a pond, the entire energy is used for a growth. The male is suitable for the monosex culture. The male or female for monosex culture is obtained in four methods. One is sexing, second one is hormonal treatment, third sterilization, fourth hybridization. Sexing means isolation of male and female fingerlings manually is called sexing. The fry and fingerlings are collected from the wild. The males and females are identified by observing the genital papilla. The male has a single opening on the genital papilla, but the female has two openings. Then second one is hormonal treatment. The fingerlings are fed with androgen along with the feed. These hormones converts all females into males. Then next step is sterilization. The tilapia is exposed to 42 degrees Celsius at the time of chymatogenesis. This temperature shock induces triploid and polyploid in the eggs. Such eggs cannot be fertilized by the sperms. Hence, overpopulation is stopped. Then finally, fourth one is hybridization. The crossing of two varieties is called hybridization. The resulting offspring is called hybrid. Hybridization of selected species produces only male hybrids. For example, when male tilapia mozambica and female tilapia are crossed, the resulting hybrids are 100% male. Similarly, tilapia hornorum and female tilapia mozambica are crossed with, the hybrids are males. Then, polyculture. The culture of many species of crabs in pond is called polyculture. All the three Indian major crabs can be cultured in single pond. The Katla is a surface feeder and feeds on plankton. Its life mostly on the surface of water. Then Rohu is column feeder and it feeds on filamentous algae. It lives in the middle zone of the pond. Then Mirga is a bottom feeder feeding on debris and worms. It lives in bottom of the pond. In Indian major crabs, Katla Katla, Labio Rogita and Cyprinus Mirgala. Katla Katla is a surface feeder, Labio Rogita is a column feeder, Cyprinus Mirgala is a bottom feeder. We culture in three methods, that means three species combination, five species combination, six species combination. In three species combination has Katla, Rohu, Mirgal. 3:6:1. In 5 species combination, Katla, Rohu, Mrigal, Common Carp and Kaveri Carp. 6:3:5:4:2 ratio. Then 6 species combination is called Katla, Rohu, Mrigal, Silver Carp, Common Carp, Grass Carp. This ratio is 3:2:4:6:4:1. And this picture shows the Indian major carps and all exotic carps. The integrated fish farming is an important one. It's defined as culture of fishes along with agriculture or animal husbandry or salt industry is called integrated fish culture. Culture of fishes in paddy fields is an integrated fish culture. Rearing of cow near a fish pond is an integrated fish culture. Integrated fish culture provides the following advantages. Single labor, double income. No need for artificial feeding. No need for additional fertilizer. Recycling of waste. Maximum utilization of natural resources. No additional cost. The integrated fish culture broadly classified into 3 types. The types of integrated fish farming classified into 3 types. They are agriculture cum fish culture, animal husbandry cum fish culture and salt industry cum fish culture. Agriculture and cum fish culture means the culture of fishes along with agriculture crop is called agriculture cum fish culture or paddy cum fish culture. Then animal husbandry cum fish culture means it's fish culture along with any one of the domestic animal. Salt industry cum fish culture means the salt industry cum fish culture prawns and fishes are reared in salt. It's called salt industry cum fish culture. The paddy cum fish culture is a best example for the agriculture cum fish culture. It has a few types. Alternate paddy cum fish culture, relay paddy cum fish culture. Alternate paddy cum fish culture means the culture of fishes in paddy fields after paddy harvest is called alternative paddy cum fish culture. The relay paddy cum fish culture means it's farming in extended even after paddy harvest. The second one is animal husbandry cum fish culture. It also has 4 types: dairy cum fish culture, poultry cum fish culture, pig cum fish culture, and duck cum fish culture. The fish culture with any one of the domestic animal is called animal husbandry cum fish culture. The salt industry cum fish culture is the best example for the artemia culture. In many of salt industry culture in Artemia.
Thank you very much for your attentions.